Hello, everyone, and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I teach you different ways to make money online and how to become a work from home freelancer. So today I'm going to teach you how you can bulk create social media posts using ChatGPT and Canva. So regardless of your business, when you are first starting out, it can take a long time to individually create a post, and it doesn't always give you the results you want. You may spend an hour creating a really beautiful post and then you get one or two likes on Instagram. But the most important thing is to build momentum and to continuously publish content on your social media platforms, because posting once a week isn't going to help grow your fan base. And it's not feasible to spend money hiring a social media manager if you're just starting out and your business isn't making any money yet. So I'm going to show you how you can save time and bulk create social media posts, and we're going to create over 100 different posts in under 10 minutes. All you need for this are three things. You need ChatGPT, which is free. You need a Gmail account, so we can use Google Sheets or Excel. And then you need Canva. So with the method we're going to use, you do need a pro Canva account. However, you can still follow along, and I'm going to show you how to do this using a free account. It just will take a bit more time. In any case, if you don't already have Canva, you can sign up by clicking on the link in the description below. So let's get started. Okay, so there are five different steps, and step one is we're going to open up ChatGPT. Now, ChatGPT is free. You can see I have a Plus account, and when you have a Plus account, you can use either the GPT-4 model or the 3.5 model, which is also for free users. So for this video, I'm just going to use the GPT 3.5 model, which is free, and that way you can see the results that you will get as well if you don't have the paid version of ChatGPT. So we're going to use ChatGPT to help us generate the content for all 100 posts. Now, the social media posts you create will depend on your business. Let's say you have a business about travel and you want to give travel tips. You might ask it to come up with 100 travel tips. Or maybe it's something to do with web design, or about pets, or about health and weight loss and fitness. In this example, let's imagine that I have a blog all about relationships. And I want to come up with 100 different posts so I can post one or two a day to try to keep building my relationship blog. So first of all, I'm going to tell ChatGPT a little bit about what I want to create. Again, you're going to customize this based on your business and what you want ChatGPT to help you create for your social media posts. Okay, so for example, I have a relationship blog helping people have healthy, loving relationships. I want to create 100 social media posts. Please help me generate a list of 50 green flags in a relationship and 50 red flags in a relationship. Now let's click enter and see what ChatGPT comes up with. So you can see it has just come up with a huge list, 50 different green flags, and 50 different red flags. You can see here it stops. I'm just going to click continue generating, so it continues the list until it gets to 50. So I think ChatGPT has done an amazing job of this, but let's say you wanted these to be a bit longer or you wanted something a little different. You can just ask ChatGPT to regenerate the list and add an extra sentence or make any adjustments that you want. But for the sake of this tutorial, let's say I'm happy with this as it is. So now we're going to go on to step two. Okay, so for step two, we're going to create a spreadsheet. Now, if you have Microsoft Excel, you can use that. And if not, you can just use Google Sheets, which is free. All you need to have is a Gmail account. So go to google.com/sheets and then just click go to sheets. Make sure you're signed into your Gmail account. Then just click here on blank. And this will open up a new spreadsheet. You can give it a title if you want by clicking here. Let's put relationship blog, green flags. So now we'll go back to ChatGPT. So now we need to copy our list. Now you can click copy by clicking on this icon here, but we want to copy from where the list begins. So I'm going to highlight my mouse right here where it says open, and just click on my mouse and scroll down to highlight the first 50, the 50 green flags. Then you can press Ctrl+C on your keyboard to copy or right click copy. And now we'll go back to Google Sheets. And then right here, just click on this first box, the A1 box, and press Ctrl+V to paste. And that has pasted the entire list into this spreadsheet. So you can see that there are 50 in total. Okay. So now let's go File, download, and we're going to download this as a .csv file. So click on that. So that should be visible in your downloads folder. You can see here, I've got my relationship blog, green flags. So in my case, I'm going to do two sort of templates. One would be for the green flags and one would be for the red flags. So I would just quickly go file, new spreadsheet. I'm going to title this red flags. Go back to ChatGPT and just copy all of the red flags. And then once again, clicking on A1 and then control V. And you can see we've got our 50 red flags, then file, download. And we're downloading this as a .csv file. The benefit of naming it at the top here is that when you download it and it saves, you can see it has saved it as red flags and then my other one as green flags. And that way I know which document is which. So now we're going to open up Canva. And this is my favorite part. If you don't already have Canva, you can sign up using my link in the description below. And usually they offer a free trial of the pro account. So you can try this method out. And if not, if you don't want to get the pro account and you already have the free version, don't worry, you can still follow along. It will just take a bit longer to generate these social media posts, but we can still do it very quickly. Okay, so now we've opened up Canva, and basically you're going to search for the type of template that you want to create. In this example, we're creating Instagram posts, and the Instagram post size is the square size, and this is something that you can also post on Facebook, on Pinterest, whatever you want. So it's a great post size if you want to use the same content for all your different platforms. So what I'm going to type in is you can just go Instagram post and then click here on Instagram post square to have the 1080 by 1080 dimensions. And you can see there are so many different templates, over 400,000 different templates that you can choose from. So you might want to use some filters and find something that's related to your theme. If you're doing something corporate related or business or education related. Another thing you can do at the top is, let's say, I'm going to type in Instagram quote. Let's say you have a weight loss blog or a fitness blog and you want to create a bunch of inspirational quote posts. You could choose something like this because essentially we're going to create one template and then put all of our content in that template. So I actually typed in red flag and I found this template here, which is perfect for me. So I'm going to click customize this template and this has opened up our template in Canva so we can make customizations. Now, another thing I want to mention is, let's say you're still not sure about this template, you can click on design over here and search Instagram post template. So we could type in relationships or whatever you want and scroll down and find a template that you like. Now, keep in mind that the ones that are pro have this little crown here. So if you don't have a pro account, just keep scrolling down and look for ones that do not have that pro icon. Okay, so now it's time to customize this so it matches our brand. We want to use our colors, we want to use our picture and our information, our fonts, and that's going to be the template for all of our posts. So the first thing I'm going to do is add my picture here. So imagine I'm this relationship guru. I'm going to click here on uploads. And you can click on upload and drag a picture of yourself. So what I'm going to do is upload this one here. Just click and drag it into this little frame. And then I'm going to click on it and I can adjust the positioning of it so that my face fills the circle. And now let's say I want to make this a bit bigger. I'm going to click and drag to highlight all of these elements. And then I'm going to click on this corner here and just drag it. So it fills it a little bit more so it's not so small. So very importantly, right here, we have this little text box and this needs to be big enough and have enough space so that we can fit all of our different red flags. So I recommend you open up your sheet and let's say I'm gonna copy this one here and press Control plus C to copy. I'll go back to my template and then Control V to paste. All right, and that is big enough to fit it. You can change the font a bit if you want as well. Another thing you might want to do is add your brand. So we can click here on add a heading. And let's say we're going to put our Instagram. Let's say my brand is healthy, happy relationships, for example. You can put that there as well. So finally, you might want to make some changes to the text color or to the background. So to do this, let's say we're changing our text color. I'm going to click on this and then click on this text color icon and then just click on the color wheel. And I'm going to click on the eyedropper because I want it to match this red. Relationship red flags with a nice bright red. So let's say you want to change the background color. You can click on the background, then click on this icon right here, which is background color. And you can go ahead and choose any background color you want. You can also click on this icon here, then click on gradient if you want to make a cool gradient background. Another thing you can do is click here on background, and you can choose a background pattern by clicking and dragging and dropping it on the background. And you can just drag and drop any of these pattern backgrounds that you like to replace it with the current background. So I liked the gradient background I chose here with a dark red that goes with my relationship red flags. So before I do the bulk create and make all the posts, I'm going to duplicate this so I can do a green flag version. So I'm going to click File, Make a Copy, and that will open this up in another window. And it has copied the file. So I can just rename this. To rename it, I'll go to the top here and just put green flag relationship post. And then I can just change this all so it's green really quickly. So I'm gonna change the text color to green. I can change the background. And I can even change these little flags into green flags by clicking on elements, type in green flag. And then I'll just erase these little red flags and then find a little green flag I like, maybe this one, and click copy and then just paste. Okay, so now I have my template for my relationship green flags and then also for my relationship red flags. And now it's time to let the magic happen and we're going to do the bulk create. So this is really fun. We're gonna click here on apps and then under search Canva apps, type bulk, enter. And then we're going to click bulk create. You could see that's added it to the bottom here. So we're going to click upload CSV and we're going to upload our red flag one that we saved earlier. So I'm going to click relationship blog red flags. Click on that. Okay, so now it has been uploaded and it says right here, right click an element in your page to connect it to your data below. So what that means is we're going to click on our text box because this is where we want it to input the information from that file. We're going to right click on it, connect data, then click right here and then click continue and then click generate 49 pages. It says 49 pages because the first one we've already done. And just like that, it has created us the remaining 49 posts because we already have our original post. And look at it, it's perfect. We've got disrespectful behavior, insults, belittling, or demeaning language. Scroll down, controlling attitude, dishonesty. And because of the template that we created, everything fits perfectly. It's just perfect. I don't have to make any changes on any of these. They're all perfect. If you wanted, you could go through and, you know, maybe make this bold or something like that. But essentially, it's all just perfect. So now all I would have to do is download this. So I can click share and then click download. And then I'm going to download all the pages. Just click download. And that's going to download all of it into a zip file. And just like that, when you open up your zip file or extract your zip file, you have all of your social media posts and you can go ahead and just upload these to your Instagram or your Facebook or whatever it is. So now we would just do the same thing with the relationship green flags. Again, you should just be able to click bulk create right here now that we added the app. Once again, you're gonna upload the CSV. Again, this feature is only available with Canva Pro, so I'm going to show you what you can do if you don't have that in a second. We'll locate our green flags, and that will upload. And then once again, you're going to right-click and choose Connect Data. So imagine right now you don't have the pro account of Canva, you just don't have the money for it, that's okay. What you can do instead, it's also really easy and it doesn't take so long. What you'll do is once you've created your template, click here on duplicate page. So this would be number one, and now we're on to number two. So you'll just open up your spreadsheet or open up ChatGPT, and we've got green flags. Number one is open communication. So we'll copy that, go back into our document, control A to highlight, control V to paste. So there's number one, scroll down, go back. Number two, copy, go back again, control A, control V. All right, then we're going to click duplicate page again, and then we're on number three, control C, control A, control V. Those are the three keys. Control C, control A, control V. So once again, we duplicate, go to number four, control C to copy, and you just keep going through. So it would take a little bit longer to do all 50, but still not going to take you longer than 10 minutes. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. There are so many different possibilities. You can do this not only for Instagram posts, but also for reels and even make videos. And it's just a great way for you to bulk create content when you don't have the time to individually create one by one all of these posts and you want to continue building your brand and your business. So thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to click like if you enjoyed this video and make sure to subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one. I'll see you in my next tutorial.